हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू पॉलिटी क्लासेस। टुडे विल बी डीलिंग विद द लास्ट चैप्टर, 10th चैप्टर ऑफ एनसीईआरटी क्लास 11 पॉलिटिकल साइंस, इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एट वर्क। दिस चैप्टर डील्स विद द फिलोसॉफी ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया। अपार्ट फ्रॉम लॉज, ऑन व्हाट फिलोसॉफी द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया इज बेस्ड ऑन, वी शैल सी दिस इन दिस चैप्टर। We'll see what are the moral content in the Constitution of India. Then we'll see why the study of philosophy is important. Then we'll see the core features of the Constitution of India. What constitutes the core features? There are total 5 core features that we'll see ahead. Finally, we'll see the criticism and limitations of the Constitution of India. With this intention, we shall begin our class, that is dealing with what is philosophy of Constitution of India. Okay, so we shall begin with this question in our mind: what is the philosophy of the Constitution of India? See, Constitution consists of laws, but Constitution does not consist of merely laws. If it would have been, then the constitution would have been legalistic and there would have been no political approach in the constitution, but it's not so. And at the same time, it's true that all laws do not have moral content, but many laws do have certain values and it contains moral content. For example, there is a law which there is an article or also a law in the Constitution of India which prohibits discrimination on the grounds of language, religion, race, caste, sex of birth. So this particular law is based on the value or the idea of equality. Hence we can very well say that of course there exists connection between laws and the moral values existing in the society. So one thing we can conclude, that every law does not have values, but many law do or are connected with values. So we'll see what is the meaning of political philosophy, or what is the political philosophy approach to the constitution. When we say this, we have three things in mind. First, the conceptual structure, or what is the conceptual structure of the constitution. This we can come to analyze when we see the meanings of the term rights, citizen, minority and democracy. Furthermore, we should also see that the constitutional framers, when they were creating the constitution of India, they would be having coherent vision of society and polity. What kind of society and polity they wanted to create? They had definite ideas in their mind. Finally, you have to check out the debates going on in the Constituent Assembly, wherein you can find many kind of justifications for the articles based on certain values. So finally, we can say, does it mean that all constitutions have philosophy, or only some constitutions have philosophy? Kindly think over this. And here we'll see that finally laws are connected to values. For example, in Constitution of India, there are several articles. So these article, example 14, equality before law and equal protection of law. Article 15 of the Constitution prohibits discrimination only on the ground of race, religion, caste, sex of birth. Then Article 16 of the Constitution of India provides equality of opportunity in the matters of public employment. Article number 17 abolishes untouchability, and Article 18 prohibits title. So these 5 articles are based on the value of equality. So every constitution not only contains laws but also contains value. So our constitution of India, we can say, is based on the value of equality, and it is because of this value of equality there are article number 14, article number 15, 16, 17 and 18. So this was the connection we have seen between laws and values in the society. So you will see that Japanese constitution, here we can have the example of Japanese constitution, which is based, which is also called as peace constitution, which is based on the ideals of peace. Kindly go through this example. So we can see that when we take into consideration the political approach, we always see the moral contents and interpretation and various ideals on which the Constitution of India is based on. Then we will see that constitutions are an instrument or a democratic instruments for a social transformation. The same thing we can say regarding the members of the Constituent Assembly. They wanted to bring social transformation, and so they had constitution. It was through constitution they wanted to bring social transformation in India. Here you can compare the America of 18th century when its constitution was written, and it is absurd to apply values and standards the era of 21st century. However, in India, the world of original framers and our present day world do not have changed drastically, particularly in terms of values, ideals and conception. So we cannot separate ourselves from the world of the members of the Constituent Assembly when they framed the Constitution of India. Now, having seen this, we will see what is the political philosophy of the India Constitution. What philosophy is of our constitutions? How can ordinary citizen understand this kind of hidden political philosophy? So we can see that our constitution rests on the ideas of egalitarian secularism, federalism. It is also needs to the sensitive needs of the religious and linguistic minorities, and also to historically advantageous groups. Our constitution also tries to create a common national identity. So now we'll see the pillars on which the political philosophy of the Constitution of India is based on. The first one, or the first pillar or the philosophy of the Constitution of India, is individual freedom. Now this concept did not emerge on the table. Rather, it was the product of a century. Remember that during the modern history, you have learned the contribution of Raja Ram Mohan Roy.